Oh, hello. So, today, I would like to talk about something that I think, really needs to be dealt with. So Jason Blaha, okay, I know a lot of you guys think he's a nut bar, but, you know, maybe he is, but you know something? He brought up a really good point in his latest video where he was talking about how bodybuilding was probably going to fall off the scene in YouTube fitness. Now, I'm not going to say whether or not, I'm not even going to comment on whether or not that's going to happen. Because I don't really care, to be honest. But he brought up a really good point that he didn't really elaborate on, and that was this. A lot of us in the fitness world, a lot of us who are into fitness, who lift weights, who want to get into better shape, whatever, right? Want to get stronger. We have a tendency to want to label ourselves as certain things. Particularly, for example, I'm into aesthetics, okay? That to me means having a great body, having good skin, having great hair. I know you guys are jealous of this haircut, but it's mine. And none of you guys can grow it like this, to this color. Alright? God gave me this. Anyway, so, you know, having good clothes and carrying yourself well, that's what aesthetics is all about. Now, for somebody who is into building my body, you would think that I would call myself a bodybuilder, right? Well, I don't. Here's why. If you look at actual bodybuilders who are in bodybuilding competitions, I don't want to look like any of those guys. Because it has that label of building your body, it doesn't mean that everybody who builds their body wants to look like a bodybuilder. I think the people who are in those competitions, because they're either genetically elite, a lot of them are taking performance-enhancing drugs. Because of those two factors, those people who are in those competitions, yes, they are at that 1% of eliteness in that endeavor. Meaning, they probably had to spend every waking moment of their day working on their training, their eating, their posing routine. There's a lot that goes into bodybuilding that you wouldn't think. And that sort of idea of having that lifestyle, that mentality, that's not something that I want for myself. That's not what I even want to look like. I just want to have, you know, a well-built, well-sculpted physique like a Greek god, okay? That's what I kind of want to look like. And I think that having the idea of that label, where you call yourself a bodybuilder, having that label has a subconscious effect on you, I think, and it makes you think that that's what your goal is. It makes you think that. It makes you think that this is the top level of what you can achieve as somebody who's building their body. And number one, it's not true, because you need to be a genetic freak, and you need to be on performance-enhancing drugs in order to be an elite bodybuilder. Some guys can get away with not taking performance-enhancing drugs because they're just that, you know, genetically gifted. But for the vast overwhelming majority of us, myself included, we can't get to that level. And those aren't realistic expectations to give ourselves. But because of those labels, sometimes, again, that subconscious trickling effect happens where we allow ourselves to look up to people like that and say, this is where I want to get to. And I think that that's a very negative thing. Just the label itself, calling yourself that. Especially if that's not really your goal. All right? Same thing goes with powerlifting. Guys who want to get stronger, who want to perform better in their sport, you know, they do squats, they do deadlifts, they do cleans, they do bench press. That doesn't necessarily mean that they should call themselves a powerlifter, does it? Because, I mean, are they in powerlifting competitions? I did one powerlifting competition in which I did get a gold medal, and I feel very good about myself for doing that. But you know something? The boost that I got to my self-esteem from that competition was not me beating everybody in the competition. It was simply the fact that I knew where I came from as far as my strength was concerned. And so I built my strength month after month, year after year, and then I said, you know what? I'm gonna go compete. I did it, got a gold medal, boom shakalaka. But you know something? I competed with myself. I could have gotten dead last in that competition as far as my Wilk score was concerned. But you know something? I didn't. But even if I did, I would have been just as proud of myself had I lost, had I bombed, right? Because I know how strong I am, and I don't care what any judge says about it. This is how strong I am. I can do a 225 pause bench. I can do 330 squat, 440 deadlift. Those were my numbers at the meet. I can do a lot more now. But I did all of that at 154 pounds. Right? And that's pretty impressive for somebody who's as small as me. But again, I don't really call myself a powerlifter. I don't train for powerlifting anymore, so why would I? I don't have that goal of having incredible bench or having an incredible deadlift or an incredible squat. By certain strength standards, I have an elite level deadlift, but that doesn't mean that I always keep trying to get that heavier deadlift and doing anything within my power to do it, to get it. And I think that's where we start to, we have this thing where we take things way too far in the fitness world. And I think that can lead to some negative consequences, such as people who have these goals and then they realize they can't get to them, and then that's when performance enhancing drugs come into the play. And then they claim to be natural, they claim to be totally drug free, and then novices look up to them and say, oh, well, if he can do it, so can I. And then they can't, and then they have the same problem, so they go out and they do performance enhancing drugs, and it's like a vicious cycle, right? So anyway, guys, all I'm trying to say here is this: people take things way too far, and I don't want you guys to be the ones to take things too far. And another thing, actually, you know what, no. This is where we get into taking things too far. And I'm not even just talking about performance-enhancing drugs right now. What I'm talking about is having a part of your lifestyle, a hobby, you know, that should just be that. You know, you making yourself a little bit better every day in a certain regard, and making that one goal consume all of your energy for the day and override all of your other goals. Like, for example, I know a lot of guys who can't put the weights down for 5 minutes, and you know, go study for an exam that they have. Because if you're in university, that means that you want to do something with your life, right? If you're trying to get a business degree, like I have, when I was in business school, there were weeks that I just had to either deload or completely take them off. Because I knew that if I was going to have, I only have a certain amount of time in order to complete certain goals. I have an exam next week, so I have to go 100% into this studying right here. Or I have an essay that's 10 pages that I gotta do for, you know, a week and a half from now. So I gotta get started. I gotta get started right now. So those are the situations where you have to evaluate and prioritize your goals. And I think that taking things too far in that regard, and, you know, calling yourself a bodybuilder and comparing yourself to, you know, guys like Phil Heath, you know, as a natural, you know, you don't, I think that if you do that, it's obviously, it's going to consume all of your energy and your effort. Also, it's going to drive you insane because you won't ever get to that level without his genetics and his supplement stack, as it were. So, I think, you know, there's more to life than bodybuilding, guys. There's more to life than powerlifting, and there's more to life than just following our hobbies. Just remember that your goals and your hobbies and your lifestyle, they need to be prioritized in a certain way. Of course, yes, you should go to the gym. It's good for everybody. too much of a bad thing, too much of a good thing is always bad. And this is where, you know, we have that come into play. Just prioritize your goals. Don't let your obsession of bodybuilding get in the way of your other goals. Because trust me, guys, one of the worst things that you can do in life is to get good at the wrong thing.